What's good, y'all? How y'all doing? Welcome back to another video, man. Today we're finna talk about the best coin making methods you guys can use right now, and you can make coins off of this. You probably should be using everything sparingly. Do it at your own risk. Some of these are not really risky, but I know some people don't really make coins the same way. So the first thing y'all need to be doing is Team Infinity, Team Builders. They are still profit in some of these sets. You can make coins with this, and the simple way to do it is all you have to do is buy the 80-82s as cheap as you possibly can. I say anything below 10K, and find the gold card 75-79. This margin on here is sometimes between 5 to about 9,000 coins. I would say you can knock this out in maybe 15 minutes per card, which means you can do about 4 cards an hour. I would say you probably have anywhere between 20 to about 35K an hour if you guys do this consistently and you're able to find the cards in a decent amount of time. Now, as far as finding some of the gold cards, I strongly suggest you guys to go ahead and do get a player packs for the gold cards and make that value a little bit lower, because it's hard to find the 75 through 79s on an auction block, and it's hard to find them quick. So I suggest you guys go ahead and do that instead of trying to just buy them on an auction block, because it will save you time and it will save you energy. The second thing y'all could do is y'all can build these superstars. You could build these 89s and make profit on them. It does take a long time, but this coin making method is still good. And what you do is you take get a player packs all the way from the bottom, zero, no cards in this set, and you build up all these cards. It is time consuming. It will take you about 5 hours to complete the set. But if you start from zero, you make coins while you're opening up to get a player packs by selling the power ups and whatnot, but you also able to complete an 89 overall superstar player, which you could profit somewhere around 350K. And if you divide that by 5, which if you get it done in 5 hours, that's about 70K an hour. So it's extremely profitable if you do take the time to do it. You can do it over a course of like 24 hours or whatever, but you can make 70K per hour by doing this if you guys do it correctly and you build the right card. Don't build a card that you feel like is gonna be a good asset to the team. Build one of the most expensive 89s you can find on the auction block, and that's how you determine which cards you wanna build. And like I said, you will be able to make about 350K. Some people are gonna make more, some people are gonna make a little bit less, but I think you would still average about 50, close to 100K an hour, depending on what you pull out of the get a player pack. Now, all you wanna do is open up your get a player packs and you exchange all of your 70 through 74s and your silver cards through here. You get as many of the gold cards you can get, and you just keep consistently upgrading all of these cards. Once you upgrade in all the cards, you then take your 83 through 84s, your gold cards and all that kind of stuff, and you upgrade them to 86s. Then you upgrade all of your 86s, 386s, and 183 through 84, and you will be able to build one of these 89 overall superstar players. Like I said, it is a long tail method, but 5 hours, if you're opening up get a player packs like a madman, you will be able to make some coins. The third method in this video is get a player packs. Now, get a player packs can be used to create many sets in the game, like Devontae Smith, superstar MVPs, and you can use get a player packs to complete the team builder players, but that is a whole, actually not even that bad. You really could make those players. We'll get a player packs, probably spend about 50K on get a player packs, and you'll have enough players to actually complete a team builder player. Then you make it, you sell a team builder player for about 40 some K, but all the power ups you get from opening up 50K from get a player packs, you will be able to make profit. So you could do that, but that's not what I'm telling you to do. I'm saying just open up get a player packs and sell everything on an auction block. Obviously you want to upgrade all of the cards to the highest you can, except for elites. That is up to your discretion. I like to upgrade them to 75 through 79, then sell the cards on an auction block. But sometimes it just seems better to upgrade them to 75 through 79, use those cards for sets and make even more coins if you have the coins. But if you have only a little bit of coins, you can't just open up get a player packs, take the 500 coins. So with this card right here, because you're opening up get a player packs and you're doing this for coins, you could even decide to upgrade this card, or you could decide to put them up on an auction block. So let's just say I just decided to put them up on an auction block. He's going for 700 coins, right? That's the last one sold for 700 coins 4 hours ago. So I could put them up at 700 coins. After taxes, I'll get back 630 coins, right? I end up making 130 coins off of just doing this one get a player pack, and I can complete this process over and over and over and over again. Now, if you have like 50 to 100K, you can do this over and over again. But let's say you pulled a regular silver card, you could go ahead and upgrade that card. You upgrade your low silvers to high silvers, then you upgrade your high silvers to low golds. And you can go ahead and keep recreating this process over and over and over over again and make a ton of coins if you guys just don't have any coins and you only got like 50K, 30K, 40K, you can't do this. So, for example, this 67 overall card, I would get a bunch of these cards and I will upgrade this high silver into a low gold and then upgrade the low gold into a high gold. And any power-ups I get in between, I sell those on an auction block. And majority of the time, the power-ups you do cover on your power-ups, but you don't pull a lot of power-ups from the ghetto player packs. You pull more of your power-ups from exchanging the cards. So when you're exchanging the cards, that's when you expect to make a lot of your coins back. If you pull a power-up from the ghetto player packs itself, that is still good. You're still gonna make coins, but for the most part, they're all gonna come from you upgrading your cards. Now that I gave y'all the three methods, I'm gonna go ahead and open up packs to kind of just show y'all what y'all could do when you start racking up some of your coins and you got a team together. You could give yourself an opportunity to make even more coins. Now, I'm not saying opening up pro fantasy packs is a coin making method, but what I'm saying is that when you do open up these pro fantasy packs, you do get an opportunity to make coins because you can pull some heat out of here. Now, you could cover, you could lose coins, and we get a legend card 84 overall DeMarcus Ware, and that is a solid pull. No more elites, but let's just say I didn't. Well, I ain't even gonna say that, because if I didn't pull this elite, he probably wouldn't be able to profit. There would be no profit in this one. But let's go ahead and this is why I like doing these, right? So this DeMarcus Ware is probably gonna sell for like what, 20K? Okay, 23K, even upwards towards 30K 2 minutes ago. So let's just say he sells at 30K, we get back 27K. This pack cost us 14K. We take that back, we profited 13K. You know what I'm saying? Like, this is the way you can make coins. I'm not saying this is gonna happen every single time, but this is how you consistently can keyword make coins. And you also get all of these other cards for the set. So technically these three, high overall silver cards could be upgraded into a low overall gold. We could sell these two golds on an auction block, and now we made 15K from spending 14K on a pack. This will not happen all the time. Definitely won't, because you will get packs that suck, and you will get packs that are better than others, but you're hoping to pull something crazy. Like, I didn't expect to pull that, but I'm hoping to pull something even better than that. Coin quick sales, 87s, 89s, all these type of cards are in packs, and you do have an opportunity to pull anything. So that's why I think that it's crucial for you guys to be pulling packs in a sense. Like, do it at your own risk. But like, if you got the coins and you're not trying to build a team, like this pack right here is trash, right? Pull 79 overall Jimmy Smith. I probably lost 10K on this pack. It is what it is. Not that big of a deal, but I'm giving myself an opportunity, especially when I know how to make coins with all those other methods. I could easily pull a card that's worth 200K, 100K, even 50K and be done with these packs, and I just made 50K in 5 minutes. You know what I'm saying? So like, yeah, you can lose 50K in 5 minutes, but you could also make 50K in 5 minutes. So it works the same way. It works like easy way, in my opinion, to kind of like, you know, give yourself an opportunity to have more fun with the game, because I know people want to open up packs and you don't have to spend money this way, and you can get your pack like addiction out. You feel me? Like, because I know for a fact that I have a pack addiction. I'm not even going to sit here and cap. I want to open up packs. Every single day I wake up, I want to open up packs. A new card come out, I want to open up packs. Open up packs at your own risk. Let's just put it like that. But I feel like I can't stop opening up packs until I pull an elite. And honestly, a power up is gonna have to do, bro. That should have been Tyreek Hill, though, for real. If that was Tyreek Hill, I probably would stop, for sure. But yes, man, I hope y'all enjoyed this video. I'm gonna see y'all next one. I'm out. Peace.